How are you?
I'm not high enough up.
You need a couple more cushions. She needs a couple of cushions to sit on.
I do when I'm driving.
Because she's a little lass, isn't you? 5 foot four and a half.
No, I'm not 5 foot four and a half. I'm 5 foot four shrunk. I was measured.
Not.
I was measured before I'd done a bridge. I was measured and I was 5 foot four.
Well,
so I've lost half an inch somewhere.
You have not.
I have. Because as you get older, you do shrink.
Yeah, but...
You become hobbled over.
Yeah, when you're older. Not now.
I'm old enough.
Have you got a dowager's hump?
Yeah, I've started.
She's got a dowager's hump as our lass. She's like the old
do you know,
woman.
A dowager, Sean, is connected to royalty. It's the... A dowager, and I did this in the pub quiz. A dowager is a royal woman that's lost a husband, like a duke's wife that's a widower, something like that.
Apparently.
Put in the comments if I'm wrong.
Yeah.
I think you have to have a dead husband to be a dowager. I don't ever want to be a dowager.
All right.
That's a horrible word.
Yeah. So anyway, dowager. How are you? How are you all doing? Oh, it's sunny here, isn't it? It's 16 degrees now. It was 18 degrees. And we've been...
We've been...
Out for a wander.
Out and about.
I had such high hopes for the day, to be honest.
I've had high hopes and I've had a truly good day. I mean, it ain't over yet. I partied till the last minute, me.
But honestly, I had such high hopes of going out and having a lovely day. But do you know what?
Sean, you've had a lovely day.
I always have a lovely day with you, my love.
Yeah. It's always interesting, isn't it? You've got to say that.
The word interesting isn't something that I would attach with today. Ask us, what have we been doing today, Wendy and Sean?
We went to an old market town that we don't ever go to.
Weren't you at the market town of...
There wasn't a market there, though, was there?
Driffield.
No, East Yorkshire.
We went for a wander round.
It's not far from us. It's only a few miles. We never go.
Ask how many charity shops we went into.
Two. We went in two, and in one of them, I bought... I can't say what, because if my kids are watching, they know what I'm getting for Christmas.
Oh, you are so tight.
Anyway, no. I only bought one thing. No, two things. No, three things, because one of them was an apron that I don't know what I'm going to do with. It was just cute and vintage. I know it's from the 1960s, so I bought it because it was a pound.
So I had to stand there like a lamppost, waiting for
a
ladyship.
I drag him in now. He comes in.
Yeah, but I stand there, honestly.
He comes in because I make him come in.
I don't want to browse through a dead man's pants, do I?
No, I didn't buy any dead man's stuff today. Although we have bought something really good, didn't we, as well? That cost a bit more than the charity shop. Went in an antique shop that I knew was there. And what did we see?
We bought a bell.
A ship's bell.
We bought a bell to put outside the door. So when somebody comes, instead of knocking on the door, they can go
like that.
Ring-a-ling-a-ling with a bell.
Because I'd love to, I might just go outside my own door and ring it just for the hell of it. Because that's, you know.
So ring in the new year, you can ring the bell.
It's loud.
When we used to live in an old schoolhouse.
We had a
bell. A number of years ago, we had a bell outside the door.
A ship's bell. And we got it engraved, didn't we, with the year we moved in, I think it was.
No, it's the year of the
the year of the house.
The house was built.
Well, this one, I'll be sending you totting off to get it engraved, Sean. So make sure you come back with it engraved.
Yeah.
But I'll have to find out the age of the house first. It could be the 18-something.
Yeah, about 1850-something.
1850-something. There's a picture of our house in the pub, isn't there?
There's a picture of our house on my phone. Decades ago, in the Victorian days, with a chap standing outside it.
Yeah, with a horse and cart. Or
no.
So the one in the pub, because we just spotted it. I said, "Oh, I think I live there," and it was a bit weird, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And it's not a big house, but it's just an old picture. Because the pub's in the village, they just drew a picture of the street, I think. But anyway, that's interesting.
So what else have we done today, Wendy?
So we've got a ship's bell, we've got a couple of
and then
shop
as we're driving down the little country lanes.
We went in a farm shop, Sean, for lunch, and it was really nice.
Yeah.
And you got scampi.
Scampi and chips.
I don't know whether, if you don't live in England, you won't know what Whitby scampi is.
Well, it's scampi. It doesn't have
what
to be.
What is it though? Is it a creature? What is it?
It's prawn pieces of prawn.
So it's
batter.
Not a creature. It's just prawns in batter called scampi.
Yeah, and it isn't all Whitby scampi. It can be prawn.
It's always Whitby scampi. Wherever you go.
Yeah, they call it that, but it isn't. Well, it's not all caught in Whitby, is it?
Well, it must be, because it says Whitby scampi.
All right, okay.
Wherever you go in Yorkshire, or indeed in England, it'll say Whitby scampi. But there's no such thing as a scampi.
No.
It's a crayfish tail or a prawn. No,
it's pieces of prawn.
I don't think it is prawn. I think it's got some fish to bulk it out as well, Sean. Because prawns are expensive and I don't think it is. I think it's got...
Because you don't get much in there.
If you know what's in a scampi,
tell us.
Because I think it's got some kind of filler in it as well.
Really? I couldn't give a monkey's. It tastes good, so...
He wouldn't eat the tartar sauce. He said, no,
but I did.
I don't like that. I said, try it. Because you know what it is, don't you, tartar sauce?
Go on, surprise
me. It's mayo with bits of gherkin chopped up in it.
Gag on that.
But you ate it.
Yeah, I ate it.
You liked it.
I draped it in ketchup, that's why.
Once he'd eaten it, he actually liked
it. And what else did we do today, Sean? I'll tell you what we did. Driving down the country lanes... There would be a hail in
the time of year.
It would be a hail in my logo. There would be stop, and I had to slam the anchors on in the car. And guess what? We passed a garden gate with a little stall outside it, and they were selling apples or toys or pears or plums or an old bike. And guess what?
I bought that.
Yeah.
For £1, it's new. It's got a ticket on.
Yeah, for who?
One of my many grandchildren. They go mad for these soft things.
Yeah, yeah. And our grandchildren will be watching this going, that's from a cart outside.
I'll give it to one of them that doesn't watch it.
All right, that's okay then.
So that's okay. I got a flump thing, whatever you call it. Mash.
But I tell you what.
Squishmallows.
So we couldn't pass anyone without having, stop!
And then where did we go?
And it's all tat.
We saw another stall. I support our local stalls. I've got a stall outside my house.
Not at the moment, you know.
But I usually do. And I sell stuff that I make. Yeah. But if I see a stall and somebody's gone to the effort of putting a little stall outside the house, I'm going to, whatever it is, I'm going to buy it.
You were one of those kids that sat at the end of your garden drive or footpath.
Yeah, I did.
Selling comics and Barbie dolls and perfume made from rose petals when you were a kid, didn't you?
I did.
And you made nout. And do you know why you did that?
I used to nick my mum's old perfume bottles. Say, have you got any perfume bottles? Or even a washing up liquid bottle. I wasn't bothered. And make rose petal perfume and sell it. I say, you have to use it fast though, because it'll go mouldy in a couple of days. It used to get a scum on it, didn't it, after a couple of days. But you did that, don't deny it.
Yeah, but I sold...
Don't deny it.
The difference is I sold quality merchandise.
No, you didn't.
As you would expect from an honest face like this.
I sold
Unlike
any tat that
this
I didn't
young
want.
Lady who would flog any sort of tat off to you.
I would sell
Ripping
anything.
Ripping you off in the process.
No, I'd sell it for a high price and come down if they didn't want it. If they said no, I'd go, well, 50p then. 20p then. But I always sold my stuff. You sold your stuff. You had a garden sale on your lawn. A few times, you told me.
Yeah,
with broken Barbies and stuff.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, I was selling all my Barbie range.
You once went to a car boot sale, Sean, and there was a broken toy, and you stuck a head off another toy on it and sold it for £5.
No, it wasn't £5.
It
was a duck's head on a giraffe.
I said, go to a car boot sale, get rid of all our old kids' toys. So off he went, and he kept piecing two
broken toys together. I put a size 12 top and added it to a size 18 bottoms on a lady's outfit. Took the labels out and flogged it. Oh, it looked marvellous, love. Oh, it really suits you. That colour. Oh, it goes with your eyes. Ooh.
Did you? I want a size 18. What are you on about? A size 18?
No.
Well, where did you get a size 18?
It was when you were a big lass. I don't know.
It was a size 12.
No. This stuff we'd got from somewhere.
Had we?
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't take our stuff.
Well, I used to go car booting with Jake, and he was a demon. He'd sell anybody anything. He wasn't bothered.
Yeah, I know. Gets off his father, I tell you.
I like... Anyway, I've been round the country stalls. And there's one more that I need to go to. So prepare yourself, Sean. Because before we go home, there's another one that I want to go to.
Can't wait for that. Cheers of flowers.
Flowers, yeah. He sells flowers. I've got my free apples. That was free, that last stall. But I did give a pound just for the
gesture. Do you know what? We're going to sing a song, aren't we? We're going to merge a song, and it's a song by the Electric Light Orchestra. And as we speak, ELO, no, because they're in the beds. ELO are on tour across America, and our daughter and her husband and I think her in-laws are going to see ELO in the 20-somethingth of this month in Phoenix.
Do you know
how jealous we are? How jealous! I tell you what. If they announced some last tour in the UK, by hook or by crook, whatever the price, I'm getting tickets for us. Wherever it is, we have to go. Yeah. I tell you what, I didn't appreciate, and you didn't appreciate, just how good they are.
Well, no, but my dad did. Yeah, my dad did.
I bought that album, and then your father stole it from me.
Yeah, my father did pinch.
Out of the blue, double album.
You lent it to me, he took it off me.
Because he really liked ELO.
Hooked on classics. What do you mean,
He stole my album, that's what.
I'm going to dedicate this song to my late father, thank you very much. He'll be listening from somewhere. Never mind.
It's not Mr. Blue Sky.
This wasn't one of his favourites, but it was on the album.
It's one of our favourites, though. I love this song.
It isn't one of mine.
When you are watching, there's a video of Wembley or Bust. About 2018, ELO did a tour, and when you're watching the crowd singing to this song. Oh, it's marvellous.
Yeah, they were swaying, weren't they?
Yes.
I remember that.
Yeah. So this song is called Telephone Line, Please. It's Telephone Line.
It's like Sean said, I never answer the phone when he rings. So
This is like me. Every time... No, not every. Almost every time I call...
Almost every
her
time.
...her indoors, she never flaming
answers
the phone.
That's because I don't walk about with a phone in my hand. I've got crafts, skills and homemaking to do.
You're making me liver and onions at all?
No, I don't cook people's livers, thank you very much.
They're not people. Well, all right, Hannibal Lecter.
Animals' livers, I wouldn't dream of it.
Oh, beautiful.
I don't eat animals' body parts, thank you very much. I had a Wensleydale cheese and pickle sandwich today, if you noticed. That's because I'm now a vegetarian. I don't eat animal body parts.
You are no more vegetarian than I'm a cardboard box.
And you had scampi.
And as you can see, I'm not a cardboard box.
I'm not eating animals' body parts anymore. Not. Apart from a bacon sandwich now and again. Anyway, get on with the song.
She throws herself into it.
No, I don't. I would never eat an animal's body part.
Wendy, you don't eat steak. You don't eat chicken. What did you have for tea for last night? Chicken. But that's not an animal's body parts, is it?
No, it isn't. It isn't, actually.
What
because
is it?
It wasn't a liver or a kidney or a lung. Like, you eat haggis and it's full of lung. I wouldn't eat anything like that.
Right, so without any further ado, this song is called Telephone Line. Join in when you like. Don't forget to subscribe, comment below, thumbs up, like it, tell your friends, please.
Yeah, tell your friends.
We love you all. All of you.
Yeah, and we've had some very loving comments lately. No nastiness.
No.
Because we can't sing, we admit we can't sing,
but we're trying to spread joy to one and all.
It's not like we say we can sing and then we can't.
No, we can't. Right, so crack on and cop a load of this.
Cop a load of this. I can't hear that, Sean. Is it a telephone?
Ah. Here you go. Hello. How are you? Have you been all right? through all those lonely, 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 lonely nights. That's what I'd say. I'd tell you everything if you pick up that telephone. How you feeling? Are you still the same? Don't you realize the things we get, we're all for real, not a dream. I just can't believe they've all faded out of view.
They're just so clever.
3, 2, 1. Okay. So no one's answering. Well, can you sing a little longer, longer, longer? Oh, I'll just sit tight through the shadows of the night. Let it rain forevermore. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Doo-wop, diddy-doo-wop, doo-wah-doo-wah. Blue days, black nights, doo-wah-doo-wah. I look into the sky, the love you ain't gonna see it through. And I wonder why the little things are coming true. Oh, oh, telephone line, give me some time. I'm living in twilight.
As I do, if Jeff Lynne is watching this homage to his song, us two are your greatest fans. You won't get bigger fans. And we just want to see you sing it before we die. Don't we, Sean?
Yeah. Time's running out!
Time's running out for us.
Yeah, it is.
Time is
running out. Because we're knocking on now. So listen, thanks for coming. We appreciate you all.
Who take time out to listen to complete drivel. And the fact that I got a squishy mallow toy for £1 off a bench on the side of the road.
Anyway, thanks for coming. We're going to find another bench to buy some more tat. So we'll see you soon. Comment down below. Thumbs up. Thanks very much. Subscribe.
Tell
it's free.
Your friends.
Tell your friends.
Free. You can be entertained
go on.
For free.
See you soon.
See you soon.
Bye.